There is Sydney Ender's version, there is Hodgson's version, there is J.D. Anderson's version to start with. And besides more recent works by B. Kakoti, by B.K. Borwa, by N.K. Borman and Suniti Chatterjee. Whatever may be the origin of the word, and to quote from Dr. Anil Boro, notwithstanding the processes of assimilation and fusion, the Boros have, in his A History of Boro Literature, that's the book I refer to, the Boros have maintained their distinctive identity through the ages. What we owe to the British administrators and missionaries is perhaps their concerted efforts to document the language and the folk tales which were until then transmitted orally. Until the second decade of the 20th century, the Boro language did not have a written language. Sydney Ender's An Outline of the Kosari Grammar, published in 1884, is the first recorded book on Boro grammar. Grammar based on the dialect of Dorang district, as has already been mentioned. J.D. Anderson's A Collection of Kachari Folk Tales and Rhymes, published in 1895, is yet another contribution in bringing to the written form that which was available only in oral narratives. In this, J.D. Anderson definitely was a pioneer. Sydney Ender's monograph, The Kacharis, published in 1911, once again brought Boro folk tales, rhymes into print, besides containing chapters discussing the life and habits of the people he met in the course of his mission work. I will mention one more work here, that of Brian Houghton Hodgson's Miscellaneous Essays Relating to Indian Subjects, published in 1847, where he discusses in detail the vocabulary, grammar and structure of the Boro language, which while also comparing with other similar languages. In fact, the Linguistic Survey of India makes it clear that the term Boro, in the sense of a genric name, was first applied by Hodgson. In the course of the seminar, all the other books which I have not mentioned will come up for discussion, because there's considerable work by the administrators and missionaries. Some have already been mentioned. I don't want to go into that, because otherwise there'll be end of it, because we have 2 days of seminar and that is all you have come to discuss. Okay, so I'm just going to limit it to this. So, and all these books require study and perhaps interrogation, as well as, you know, from today's perspective. From the body of work available, it goes without saying that the missionaries and the British administrative officials did play a role in the development of the Boro language by publishing books on grammar, vocabulary, dictionary, folk tales and rhymes. As per Dr. Anil Boro's assessment, they, however, this is important, did little to promote creative writing and publishing journals the way they did in the case of the Assamese language. So, the opinion is that Boro literature proper began only in the second decade of the 20th century. Nonetheless, it can also be argued that without stability in language, there perhaps cannot be creative writing. What the missionaries initiated contributed in the discussion of the language and putting it in the written form, as a consequence of which Boro language has come to stay. These books brought the Boro tribe and languages into discussion, thus beginning the process of documentation of the languages that people spoke, as well as documenting their way of life. In the course of time, as Assamese began to be, as I have mentioned in the concept note of the seminar, as Assamese began to be the dominant language in Assam, a language consciousness grew among the Boro intelligentsia, thus sowing the seeds of the language movement which were to follow later. Through the contributions of the British administrators and contributions of the missionaries, administrators have been discussed in various platforms, in various forums, yet I don't suppose there has been a platform like this, you know, to explore the contribution towards the development of Boro language and literature. There has been a lot of studies so far as development of Assamese language, is concerned. And there are a lot of little, if we go and find on the internet, lots of works which are available. So we